My Design Rules is sponsored by Capitec. Better never rests.
Really excited to be here today, a bit nervous. We don't know what's gonna get thrown at us, and we're looking forward to the challenge. I mean, that's why we're here, to compete.
We have no idea what the festival is gonna be, but I'm thinking maybe kitchen, maybe living room, maybe powder room, I don't know.
Well, duos, welcome to the heart of the action. Now, for your first challenge, we'll be focusing on the powder room.
I'm so excited. The powder room is small and sweet.
I think the powder room is such a cool space, so you can do something completely different compared to the rest of your apartment. And that's also the space that the guests mainly use. So you can go crazy and try and impress your visitors in that powder room space.
I'm here for the crazy.
I'm definitely intrigued to see how we're going to fit it in. I mean, the apartment doesn't have a powder room as it stands, so it's going to be something that we're going to have to fit into the space, which will definitely be a challenge, but yeah. I'm really excited.
Design duos, are we ready to dive in?
Yes!
Hey, well, let's shake and bake and good luck!
Thank you!
I think the biggest challenge within this first brief is going to be timeline and planning. Because, you know, me and Hannah, we're big dreamers, so we don't always consider these things, but...
Yeah, and there's, I think, a lot of details that will be noticed in such a small space that we have to consider, and we want to do it right to really impress the judges. Yeah.
The first stop for our design duos is Continua, who focus on all things stone, from design to installation. Here they meet creative mastermind Karen Guvinila.
Meeting Karen today, she has knowledge about the product, the materials that we'll be using, which is going to be marble and scissor stone as well as porcelain. So yeah, she's going to brief us a little bit about, you know, what she has in store for us.
Take it from there.
Home run.
Well, viewers, welcome to Continua. And when it comes to natural stone, this is the place to be.
I'm Karen Guvinila. I'm the co-owner and the founder of Continua. We've got a passion for natural stone, and organically we've grown to incorporating so many materials, and Continua is basically a showcase of taking anything that's stone, wall, floor, vanity, and creating beautiful things for the industry. The powder room challenge really is something spectacular and something that should not be overlooked. It's definitely the place that your guests will probably visit once or twice and has to be absolutely exquisite.
When it comes to the attention to detail, being meticulous with design and pulling out the best of creativity, this is your lady. So use this time wisely and enjoy your tour, because it's time to find out how all the magic happens.
Continua works with premium marble suppliers, including Rudy's Choice. And to help bring their apartments to life, Rudy's Choice is gifting each duo one slab.
We're having a look at our pedestal basin of which we want to go for.
Ooh, that's stunning.
So we're hoping to rib it to get kind of this effect.
So I think we look at this stone, it's very similar to what you selected. This would be your concave fluting and this would be your bullnose fluting. Overall, I think the linear lines of this will really, really suit the style of that very square vanity, which I think will be beautiful.
Super excited to ask Karen about textures and different materials and how they can come together to create a really warm space, because marble can be very cold. I'm hoping we'll come up with great ideas.
Yeah, I think this one is much better.
Are you excited? What's happening?
Very excited.
Okay, what is the combination? What are you guys thinking?
We've come up with two options that we really think could work.
Cool.
But we sort of feel like the panda might be the one.
Yeah. Okay, so this is a panda. It's got crystallization, which is beautiful when the light hits it. I think the strong contrast between the black and the white really is quite bold. What is your theme for your bathroom?
It's air.
Oh, wow. Okay, this is pretty cool, actually. So it looks as though, like, you know, the air is literally flowing with the movement of the actual slab. Hello, hello, hello.
Hello.
What's happening over here?
So this is our wonderful palette.
We need help from Karen when it comes to, like, you know, how do we play around with the stones, what we can do with the stones,
yeah,
and what works with what best to kind of, like, just have a similar look.
What is your theme?
So our theme is earth. Yeah.
Ooh, okay, so if it's earth, this is definitely very volcanic, really earthy, yeah. Which I think is beautiful. I think I need to see a layout and I need to see drawings because visually it's a very small space. So remember, we're not fighting for attention. I'm seeing fluting, I'm seeing ribbing, I'm seeing Kit Kat tiles as well. You need to simplify it.
Karen really like gave us some good direction in the like possibilities that we can do like with our stone, and just guided us, you know, like with our palette. It actually introduced a new idea that I thought like was fire, and it looks much better now that we have actually spoken to her. So she's on top of her game.
I'd really like to settle on our choice of marble in our powder room. We've got two options, a red and a pink.
Ooh, I'm loving what I'm seeing over here. I'm loving this.
Team fire.
Fire. So. Ooh.
It's coming through in all the materials.
Yeah. Okay, what are you thinking? Tell me.
We are just admiring this stone. I think it's going to be what we go for.
Is this the stone you're going for? It's one of my favorites.
Yes.
Can I tell you, it's an all-time classic.
Amazing.
But to redefine it is really, really smart. Adding texture, adding clean lines will elevate it to be completely relevant.
We're just admiring all the like different textures on the surfaces. So we'd love to get your input as to how to make it as striking as possible.
I'm thinking fire. So if we overly sandblast it, you'll actually, when you touch that over there, can you feel how rough and textural it is? So we could actually do the front of your vanity super textural.
Yes.
So it's almost like it's been in a fire and now it's been left over and you've just found this amazing antique piece of marble,
which
I think will be super stunning. It tones down the colors a bit. So in its natural form, as you can see, it's quite shiny, quite glossy, very boutique hotel.
Yeah.
Whereas the moment you do this, it adds a lot more sort of like natural elements to it. So I think with fire, it will be incredible.
Karen is such a bold woman, and I think with a theme like fire, we really can show up and do something impressive, even though it is such a small space.
Yeah.
But I'm gonna use all our ideas to wow her at the end. I can't wait to see how it comes together.
Very excited.
I've never been a judge before, but I am extremely, extremely critical. So I'm so excited to see whether the contestants have taken in the knowledge, taken in the technical elements, and have literally delivered.
After soaking in all of Karen's experience, the duos get started on their powder room designs, finding ways to incorporate stone while maintaining the essence of their themes.
Keith, you know me, Pinterest in real life.
I mean, I always say you have a PhD in Pinterest, so yeah. I'm thinking have the powder room like in the center of the space, kind of like having like that dramatic marble as well. Essentially that represents the heart, which is red.
Yeah, love that, Keith. I'm leaning towards like a sanctuary, like a wow factor, making it our bold, bright colors, bringing in like something that's different to the rest of the apartment. Instead of that blue, like I much rather prefer something with a bit of glass, because this doesn't it also make a curve or a space feel like flat? Maybe if we take the water blue theme throughout like the lounge and the kitchen, then I think this green will really stand out and be its own pop of color.
With the powder room, you don't want to overextend your creativity. It's such a small space, so you have to know what's in the background, what's popping out.
Yeah.
So we'll go like, let's say for three colors, because that's how we'll kind of like break it down. Mm-hmm. It'll be like properly, like impactful visually. You know, you don't want to do too much.
So essentially what Amy and I have done at Continua, we've taken a flat piece of marble and we actually took these strips and we've laid it on this little marble picture here, and we could actually see the exact same pattern that we want to wrap around the marble plinth. We want the plinth to actually enhance that basin on top of it.
Design saved my life, you know, because it's like, if you don't feel like it's purposeful, you're just like a chicken with the head off, just running around. You
know? Headless, yeah.
Yeah, headless chicken and like, you know, no direction. Design definitely saved my life from the background that we have, having to focus on this, seeing that you're good at it and just working to evolve in it and just polishing it to the top has been life-changing.
Thank you.
Today, Continue is on site and we're so excited to see what's been happening behind the scenes. We've got our powder room deadline coming up very, very soon. So I've got two of my team members with me on site to do a site inspection and let's see how it goes. I'm a little bit concerned because things aren't looking great. The correspondence and the emails have been really quite far apart. I'm getting a bit nervous. So that's why Rayon's on site with me. We need to work our timelines, production, so things are getting a little bit stickier, but we're here to be solution driven and to get things sorted. As I enter here, where's the toilet? There's no markings, there's no plumbing, there's no substructure. And if you've got over a week or so to fabricate this,
timelines are not enough.
I haven't got renders, I haven't had any technical drawings.
They discuss any material with you as yet?
They have sent a visual of their final selection, but nothing's been ordered or delivered to the factory.
One major query that we would like to discuss with Karen is how to actually construct our carcass. So a carcass is what goes under the marble, what supports the marble.
Well, you've asked us for a substructure drawing, which Weston has done. I feel as though we've taken over your entire design. So you've given me a reference on Pinterest. We've designed it for you. So where's your take on it?
That was actually Zweli's design.
Which design?
That.
Yeah.
Yeah, the substrate.
Yeah,
yeah, Zweli designed that.
The misunderstanding on our drawing, I think it's a good thing that she thought our drawing was from Pinterest, but I actually designed that myself. So the brief is, here's our marble design, vanity design. We need a carcass, like what goes inside of that.
Think, how would you assemble it if it was you? Think of the componentry that you'd require. So you need to backward engineer it. This is Hannah and Keaton. So they are Team Fire. I am obsessed with the design.
Okay.
An interesting fact that Keaton and Hannah, they aren't interior designers at all. They
like
want to have
it's
a hidden drawer.
The drawing, yeah.
There's no talk of lighting, so I don't know where, what, how. So I've got no idea of the entire space at all, except for the vanity that we've designed. Great. Let's get them in. Teamwork, woohoo! Yeah. Hi!
Hi, Karen.
How's it? Team
Group
Fire.
Yes.
Team B. Okay, let's get cracking. What's happening?
Slightly overwhelmed, but I mean...
But that's okay.
Yes.
Part of the process. So I know that we have helped you out with the optimization. So this is your actual vanity. There has to be support structure underneath the actual vanity because the weight of the marble is going to drop.
Yes.
Are you using steel? Are you using marine ply? What is your plan? Have you even got a design for that?
Gut feelings are guardian angels. My guardian angel is saying, we might not make it, but do you know what? We can just pray at this point.
When you're looking at the actual render or the SketchUp model, it looks so big. It's tiny. I mean, they've got glitz, they've got glam, they've got polish, they've got subway tiles, and it sounds amazing, but I think it's gonna be very tight.
Mm. They have no drawers and no storage space, which is understandable because it's such a small space.
Mm.
But we also feel the vanity, once again, is too big for the space. I mean, it's taking up more than half of your space. Where's your toilet gonna go?
It is tiny.
It is quite tiny.
And it's very tricky to execute something that looks lush and elaborate, and you guys want it sophisticated in a very small space.
Yeah.
Your vanity fair, your depth is 400.
Yeah.
Your carcass is 400 too. So where's your allowance for stone?
Ooh.
It's a major mistake. Luckily, I'm here to pick it up.
Yeah.
So it's either process or people that make issues on site. And currently you guys are the people that's messing up my process. So when it comes to process, carcasses need to be installed before I even come to templates. This is my, I'm freaking out about this team.
Sure, there's not a lot
So
going
there's
on.
No papers, there's no design, there's no concept that's been refined. Amazing ideas, but they're the only contestants that didn't enter as team, and there's a lot of, I can feel.
The communication is slacking.
Very different designs. I think they're making their substrate themselves. It's gonna be cylindric, cool shape.
Literally themselves are getting it?
No, literally themselves.
Okay.
Timelines. Hey guys.
Hi Karen.
Hi, how are you feeling?
Excited. Maybe excited.
Nervous.
I would be nervous, petrified, because you guys are the least prepared so far.
Yeah.
I'm already feeling that there's a clash of personality, there's no teamwork, and I love the independent ideas. I think you guys are really amazing individuals, but I just feel there's no synergy between the team. Right now, if I was your client, I would have fired you by now, to be very honest.
Yeah.
Yeah, well.
I didn't expect to go that, you know.
I need to come in, I need to measure templates, fabricate, and then install with four other units. So my point is, you guys are holding the entire site back because I need to come one day and do everything. I haven't seen any visuals, no references. I'm your client, ultimately. I'm the judge on this challenge.
Okay.
Okay, but there's still time. I think the team just need to take a deep breath, regroup, look at their schedule and their timelines, and work together with all of their suppliers. So we definitely can get there.
How much can you endure? This is how much we can. Caesarstone, designed to endure life.
Stand a chance to win a weekend away in the winning apartments with Buco. Dial *120*62800# and follow the prompts to enter. Begin with Buco. The design duos are hard at work on their powder rooms, and with only 5 days left till the deadline, the reality is starting to sink in. Will they get done on time?
We have got 5 days for the powder room to be complete, but things are looking good.
Things are looking good. I'm glad. This is why I love Hannah, because she's so optimistic.
We have a door.
We have a door.
I mean,
let's celebrate that, you know? When God closes one door, he opens another.
Okay, so currently we've got the door frames that are already put in. We just now need to put in some pipes here to cover it up so that the guys or the wheelbarrows don't bump into the door frame and actually damage it. But once this is done and complete, we're going to stain it. And yeah, this is going to be a very beautiful trim.
Our budget is actually looking good. I mean, we've gotten to a point now where we like are very conscious of like things that we do not need, and especially with the time as well. So some other things take a lot of money and a lot of time. So we're just like cutting down accordingly, but our budget is good.
Yeah.
It is good, right? Oh my, amazing.
It's coming together so well. I love the
green.
It has like a bluey.
And it's on, yeah? I can see the vision now. Wow.
I thought it was tiny at first. Yeah. And now it actually feels like, I mean, three people can fit in here.
Can you even hear the echo in here?
We are feeling quite nervous, under pressure.
We've lined everything up as best we can. It's just a plug and play, but hopefully everything goes according to plan.
According to the plug and the play.
Plan, yes.
So we want something with a like dusty pink undertone. You know, we don't want to go too on the nose with a color, like everybody thinks like fire, we're gonna go for red, but we kind of wanna just like imagining the color like draining the red color and then the lightest version of that, this one. So we've seen this one before and we really like it. White night. So we're gonna get 5 liters of that. I think that's enough to start with. Yeah. So I'm gonna get them to mix this for us. Johnny.
What?
White night.
White night, 5 liters.
5 liters, please. And you said that's with a matte finish.
A matte finish.
Perfect.
More good news for Hannah and Keaton as the team from Easy Life Kitchens arrives to install the wooden carcasses for their vanity. Their powder room is starting to take shape.
It is such an exciting day to be on site. We are finally getting our Easy Life carcass installed in our powder room. We have been waiting for this moment for so long, but it is finally here. The day has come and our patience has paid off.
Excited, but also just want to see the process, make sure that everything goes like quite smooth. But yeah, like it's a good day.
Our carcass is needing to accommodate for a curve in our bathroom. So we are kind of setting up a shell almost around that the marble is going to rest on. And then Karen is going to come and take final measurements and prepare the stone for us.
The measurements are a bit tricky because of the curve and the plastering that was done on the wall. I had a slight problem with the placement of the drainage pipe.
but then we're compensating by moving a little bit to our left, right?
Right.
Keeping it on the right as much as we can, so we can utilize the spaces as efficiently as we can.
One concern that I am having is the fact that our drain pipe is exposed because our vanity is quite narrow. So I'm wondering, do we either extend our marble to hide that, or do we kind of play into our theme, maybe get a brass or gold pipe, if that's even possible, to tie in with our taps? But I think either way, it could play in our favor.
The concerns is like positioning our tap and the mixers. They're gonna be built in on the wall, right? And then we'll have like a mirror in front of that, so they're gonna be popping out of the mirror. So getting our dimensions right is quite vital for the look. So we're just trying to make sure that we tick that box.
I am definitely hoping that our carcass sink lines up with the doorway. I want everything to kind of be perfect. So I'm definitely paying attention to those finer details, but I think they've taken some final measurements and it looks like everything's gonna line up.
It's amazing.
I'm happy to see the carcass in there.
To see like the space that it takes, how much space.
It isn't a lot of space, so
yeah.
It gives a lot of room to the sitting that everyone has been kind of concerned about, especially myself. But yeah, it looks amazing.
Today has been such a successful day on site. Our carcass is finally installed. Shout out to Easy Life. They've really made our lives easier. And it feels like we always have our first piece of furniture in the home, which is just so exciting. And we are now ready for the final measurements of our marble to be taken. And then that is going to be put into production. I can't wait.
Another day done and only 4 days till deadline. Stress is building as the duo split their attention between their powder rooms and the structural progress of their apartments.
There's a lot of things going on. We're feeling stressed, overwhelmed.
Yeah, there's a ton of things happening. We've got tiling going up, we've got the ceiling needing to come in, we've got the cupboard needing to come in. We're stressing about the mirror, that the tap, because our tap is going through our mirror, so we have to make sure everything lines up because the mirror sits on top of our plinth and then it has to miss the ceiling as well.
So that you don't pick up the shadow line in the ceiling.
Oh yeah. Is there a shadow in the curve?
Yeah, there's a shadow line in the curve. I think Tian's really, they are ahead of us. Yep. But at the same time, we've got a bigger space, which means we've got more tiling and more units to fit in our space. At least we've got storage.
We are making a lot of progress compared to the other teams. Did have a chance to like go past their apartments. and I think we're the only people who have all our tiles fixed,
and
basically.
Almost everything
ready. So this is actually really good.
While they were trying to chip away at our wall to put our door frame in, a piece of the brick obviously cracked our floor in the front.
Yeah.
But we're happy, at least it's one tile. It could have been the whole powder room floor and that would have been a way bigger setback.
Luckily, we have extra tile. We'll just remove the old one and then we'll place the new one. I think we'll be good.
Yeah, we have a couple of days now until we present for the powder room. So yeah, man, it's crunch time. Nervous and excited at the same time, but it's part of the game. There's a lot we have to do. They still have to do flooring, cladding, tiling, lighting, but there's a lot of great stuff coming for you guys. I'm nervous, but excited. I'm excited because there's magic, you know, so we're just really trusting the process now. We're definitely gonna be doing a lot of all-nighters here, but yeah, it's just the name of the game, you know?
As the pressure mounts, the duos take time out to reflect on their progress over a cup of Jacobs.
Help yourself.
Thank you, Papa.
To a good day.
Oh, thank you.
It's a good day.
Yo, I drank before I
got here. Cheers, guys.
Cheers. Cheers, man.
Let's give me mocha.
Yeah. Give me a mocha already.
Let's give me chocolatino.
Capri caramel.
I'll take this down one time.
Hey, what's happening, my dessert familia? How are we all doing?
Well done yourself, man.
It's good to see you tucking into the good stuff, and I'm hoping that I can tuck into some good conversation with you all because it's a big day. Mm-hmm. What's been happening? What's been going right? And maybe what's been going wrong? Now's your opportunity to be honest with me.
Well, we don't have a carcass in our bathroom yet, so that's one thing.
But we've got four walls, which is better than the two we had last week. Not plastered, but I mean, we'll take what we can get at this point. So yeah, it's coming together, slowly but surely.
Four walls is progress, I'll take it. For my gents, Sipi Papalele, what's happening in your side? Are we still cool, calm, and collected under all this pressure?
Always cool, calm, and collected. Whatever's happening outside of me is happening outside of me.
Yeah, the only man that wakes up in PJs and they look like a suit.
Literally. I mean, come on. I'm a business, man. Okay. Actually, I'm the business.
Man's woke up like this. I love it. Israeli, what's been happening on your side? You got the ocean view. You're trying to pull that into your design. Is it working? Are we winning? Are we getting it right?
Yeah, we're actually winning. So we just made a couple of changes. And I think it's actually looking really great.
Yeah, it's working in our favor.
Yeah,
excellent. I like that. Come on, guys, give me more drama. Josh, Amy, something's got to be going wrong. It can't be that easy. What's happening on your side?
We had a few hiccups during this week as well. It was a little bit frightening. But Amy and myself, we've made a team of it. And we made a team effort. And we've got our carcass here at least.
Yep.
You're pretty much on it for now, but yeah. I can't be the judge. And the real judges are going to be coming in. So how are we feeling about that? The real decisions, the real deliberations are going to be made. Are we feeling comfortable, confident?
I personally feel like it's a fresh pair of eyes, you know, like getting a different perspective from someone who's not involved in what you're doing is refreshing, and also positive criticism is, you know, always a go-to.
Constructive criticism.
Yeah. And I think that's a brilliant point to make, because at the end of the day, as much as they are judges, they also are here to assist you. Yeah. These are some of the best in the land, the cream of the crop when it comes to design and decor, and we brought them here for you. So use them, use the time that you have with them, and hopefully you can sneak some more inspirational ideas. And with that being said, I'm wishing you all nothing but good luck. Sip up on the rest of this and let the games begin.
That's for sure, man.
Good luck, guys.
Who says no to a cappuccino? Jacobs, Wunderbar.
The design duos are working tirelessly to ready their powder rooms and enhancing their designs. Each duo was gifted a slab they selected from the marble collection at Rudy's Choice. Team Air chose Panda White, Team Fire Rosso Levanto, Team Earth Rainforest Brown, and Team Water Ravine Leather.
Amazing! How amazing is this? Ah, dude.
3 days to go, and we are really happy with the progress. Our ceilings are in, the door frame is in.
And this beauty is finally here. Mm. She's ready to get installed, and we can't wait for it to just all come together.
It looks cool. Yeah, it looks very clean, man. We're gonna start with our vanity. After installing our vanity, we're jumping straight into our light box. We just need to get crunching and then tiling, making sure everything is smooth for the next 3 days.
So we've opted for the Eurolux downlights, which I think will give a really lovely display, because they're actually tilt in the case, because we're going to have a beautiful sculpture on the wall. So at least we can spot onto the sculpture and highlight its beauty.
We are fitting our light box into the powder room ceiling. This bad boy is going to be one of our main fixtures in the powder room for our ceiling. I feel like it really completes this design and makes it super different.
The lovely team from Continua is here. They're putting in our vanity. I'm losing my marbles, but we're gaining a marble vanity. So, you know, small victory there.
They just finished installing our vanity in our powder room yesterday, which is good work. And yeah, work is looking good. A lot of pressure. But at the same time, man, we got it under control.
Deadline is definitely hanging over me like a dark cloud regarding the powder room. Other things need to happen. So we've started with the klompies in the kitchen, which is going quite fast. I think we're almost halfway in the kitchen. Hopefully by the end of today, the whole kitchen is done and then we can move on to the other rooms. But we're just trying to do as much as possible with everyone here, everybody wanting to like finish their part. So we're just trying to keep the train going.
We've used these Kit Kats in the powder room and we really wanted to use it into our ensuite through the bedroom into the bathroom. But these are mosaics and they're really expensive. So fortunately at CTM, they had an option for a tile, which is also smaller in size, so we could wrap it around the curve. So really grateful.
We just finished priming now. The primer just dried, so I'm gonna apply a black coat of paint to just finish the touch.
So there's always challenges along the way when you are designing, right?
I don't know, I was always taught to like to rest at the end, so just like for me it's always go time until it's time to rest, and we don't rest in the middle, we rest at the end. So like it's not really like being worried, but like it's like anything can happen, so I have to be like laser focused, you know, and just make sure everything's on point.
So I'm done with my painting. The only thing left now is perspex.
Klompies are looking so good. We love it. The pattern that we've decided to go on is going to create the most depth and the most flow space-wise. So yeah, I think we're happy with our choices. I mean, we're halfway there, so we just gotta make peace with what we've decided on.
There's more adrenaline when you're on sites. I mean, your brain is constantly like working. You have to solve problems.
In the moment, on site.
Come up with solutions. And that's always like exciting, especially because you know that the product is being built.
Mm. Yeah. And you can be happy with it.
Look at this sexy vanity. I mean, I am absolutely obsessed. It's a little bit dusty, so you can't really see it in its full glory, but they've just finished about everything. They've drilled the hole where our tap is going. So let's just get a little bit of a feel for what that's gonna look like. So we want it at an angle so that when you wash your hands, it's not like, you know, your natural instinct is to put your hands inside the sink. So yeah, we've perfectly measured that so that it's comfortable for everyone.
We are really happy that the vanity shelf is in, because at some point we thought it was going to come in after the judging, which was really scary. It was really scary because that shelf is sort of like the focal point or like the main attraction of the powder room.
The shelf goes up to here. That means we have to remove these two tiles and then replace them with the green so that like the green can envelop the whole vanity. I think it'll be a quick fix.
Faisal might not be too happy with us.
Yeah, our tilers will be so mad, but it has to happen.
So guys, we have gone with the White Knight from Plascon. You know, when you think of paint, Plascon is the first one that I think of. So yeah, it's coming out really nice.
The guys just worked overtime, the tilers, man. Beautiful work, and I feel like right now it's time for me to reward them, you know, because every man that works hard needs to be rewarded. Let me just make this payment for them, and we all happy. But yeah, man, that's done. Let's continue working. The show's not done yet.
This is just not it. It's supposed to have like a two-tone color, like either you go with one shade light or one shade darker. That.
But how are we gonna do that?
I'm not the painting professional. That's why you tell me.
Okay.
There's just so much going on. There's a lot that needed to be done. We had our days mapped out. A, B, C over the week, and it just didn't go according to plan. And to know that you keep on working on the last day, or it's not even gonna get to a point where it's completed. It's rough.
Guys, we've basically got the whole building site here now, trying to center our door, skim the walls, plaster the walls, paint the walls. Then we've also seen the doors a bit skew. Like me.
It's the last minutes, stressful times, time is against us. But yeah, we have to find a way to just pull something out of somewhere and just make this thing happen. Yeah, we better put our mirror there, put our wall lights. Everything is looking good, but the final touches are what makes it count. So yeah,
I'm stressed.
I'm so stressed.
Grout, grout, grout. I love grout. Okay, guys, I'm looking for a very specific color for the grout today. We don't want it to have too much of a contrast with the chrome piece right now. So I know some people like the look to have the white grout with the exposed brick look, you know, but we wanted to blend in a bit more. I feel like it's such a statement already. So I just kind of wanted to blend in. It looks like this might be the closest. Dark brown. I think it's gonna be this one. I'm feeling good about it. Let's hope Hannah feels the same.
Here I've got the tile that we are using throughout our whole house from CTM, this beautiful, narrow, clumpy. And in our bathrooms, we are going for a more square paver in the same kind of range, but we are actually the first people to be using it. It's still come directly from the supplier, but soon it's gonna be at CTM, which is so exciting.
Let's hear it for who?
CTM!
Oh, that Tyler is worried. He's very worried. I wish it was easy, but you know, these things are never easy. You know, takes time, takes patience. You know, sometimes you have to like calm down a bit so you can like make better decisions, but we'll get there.
So we went to Buco, we asked for, you know, a bag of sand. They said we can just mix it to, you know, your own discretion. I really like it. I think sometimes when you've got an idea in your head, you just get hyper-fixating on that, but I'm happy with this.
I'm struggling.
No. It's gonna be all right. On the bright side, everyone else is stressing about this thing. Everyone else is like on their toes and walking on eggshells.
Yeah.
So I just think we should calm down.
Keep going.
We keep going, we keep pushing.
Got this.
We've got this.
Whether you're looking for a lock up and go, or a settle down and grow, an office for your booming business, or a safe haven, we have a space for you.
Tech. Do it all on our app. Just like that.
Our dynamic duos have been working right throughout the night to make sure that their powder rooms are up to standard. Now our judges are about to arrive and they are eager to see what our designers have put together.
We just have a couple more things to get through now this morning.
Yeah, finish up the last bits and pieces of it, the decor, and cleaning.
That dust gets everywhere.
Everywhere.
We still have quite a bit to do, but I feel like we've got a to-do list and we just got to start ticking.
I got this crazy idea.
He had a revelation. Yeah.
So I saw this mural and how like it worked, you know, on the ceiling and on the wall. But I guess like we didn't have the right colors. It was like such a late thought. So we couldn't like execute it the way we wanted to. So the guy brought the wrong colors. So yeah, it went south from there.
So the idea was to have it in the background. And when the light kind of comes on, there's gonna be perspective and it's gonna get the shape of the actual light bulb. Looks like I took a wrong turn here. But I'll do my best to teach it, but we're running out of time and yeah.
Yeah.
Hang our mirror, making sure the green is
nicely grouted
and nicely cleaned as well, because the grout leaves like residue.
We feel very good going to the judging. I think the judges will have a good chance to like see what they need to see and judge accordingly.
Contestants! Up, let's head outside and meet your judges.
Oh, okay. Come, let's go.
Over to the judges.
Over to the
judges.
Will
they get it?
I hope they do. And if they don't, then
they don't matter.
I think it definitely seems as though they wanted a big reveal. So let me assist you, cry.
Can you even hug
the way?
Yeah.
Wow.
Judges, officially, what are your thoughts
as you have just stepped into our first powder room? Obviously, this is Josh and Amy with Air.
Much bigger than I thought it would be. I was worried. I was a little worried. This vanity is unbelievable. It really is. I mean, I've seen a lot of it, but it's also very innovative. I haven't seen that.
As you walk in, your attention is immediately drawn to the vanity. They've plotted the veining themselves, so that was really key. I think the balance between sort of nature and the sophistication is spot on.
The rounded edges of the wall, beautiful on the inside. I want to see what that's going to do to the outside space and how they're going to incorporate that into the rest of the unit.
Aha! Okay. Oh. Okay, this.
You like it?
I like this.
I'm not feeling that it's sticking to the theme. I had my reservations regarding the green tile initially, and they were saying it's an aqua sea kind of firm, but I feel like it's so much going on.
I'm going to start with the vanity because I think that's where the theme is translated.
Yes. Okay.
And maybe if I put on my marketing hat, I see waterfalls.
Okay.
Okay. However, I must agree that the green relative to the theme is still a concern for me.
Ooh, wow.
Ooh.
You.
This feels like I'm in a wine farm.
Well, of course, this is Hannah and Keaton with the theme of fire, and looks like you have some opinions on this one.
The theme is so subtly translated, because I'm scared of a theme. I'm a little bit nervous.
Especially fire, yeah.
Oh, but this is so beautifully done. The little candle.
And the smell, the scent, you're overwhelmed with the feeling of
fire. The nuances that they've really paid attention to are very, and the curve, and I'm impressed.
I was quite nervous about the size of the vanity, and their powder room, actually, I think it's the smallest out of everyone's. It's super narrow, but the use of space is extremely elegant, sophisticated, and then the marble, which is texturized, I absolutely adore it.
The fire theme is what I'm struggling to really see come out here.
What?
Definitely, I'm not seeing it.
Touch
the
vanity.
Eye of the beholder. Yeah, this is very, very bespoke. It makes me think of an old wine farm, quite distinguished. So how this style translates into the rest of the home is what I'm really curious to see.
Sipe and Papilele's powder room, their theme is earth. And some interesting points to just note is that I think they had an interesting challenge when it comes to their ceiling. They opted for a very creative mural, which I'm noticing now is no longer there. So this seems to be a contingency, I think, but your overall thoughts on this room?
I'll let you start as the mentor.
I think Val and I, we're quite simplistic, and I think that the space is really crowded.
Too much, it was too
way
much. There would never
too
be
much
there
going on. The color of the wall is bold, and I love it.
It's beautiful.
I think it balances quite nicely with the floor. I would have liked a bit of a warmer timber though, in my opinion, just to kind of like bring up the whole earth theme. I'm just questioning the black accessories with it. I just don't know what I would have used instead.
It's not just that it's not done, it's that it's not done right. There's blatant mistakes, you know, things aren't straight.
So close, but time management maybe jeopardized how they could execute.
It's time for us to find out who our winners are. Before we do though, let's talk about who we feel are in the bottom two for this challenge. Our first team at the bottom of our list for today's challenge. Val, yes?
Team Water. I'm sorry, team. The color of your green was a bit of a problem for us, you know, and we also understand that maybe it was an interpretation of water in a kind of river sense, but it did feel like a bit of a departure.
Well, what do they mean?
That's the reaction.
It's fine.
Yeah.
Take it on the chin.
Yeah.
I don't know if we agree with it, but I feel like our green was trendy, it was out there, it was a pop of color, and it might have been a bit risky, but we were willing to take it.
And now our second team in the bottom two for this challenge, Lesejo, is?
Well, this is tough because I think they executed the theme the best, but unfortunately, Team Earth. is also in the bottom two. You guys did make mention of the fact that you're going to take risks and you're not going to, if you don't elevate yourselves, you can't get any better. You also need to remember that you only get one chance to get it right.
Beauty is in the eye of the beholder. In that setting, I feel like a black toilet would work.
That obviously means that our two teams that are in the top two for this challenge are both fire and air.
Top two.
I couldn't believe it. I can't believe it.
I'd like to start with Team Air. I love the way that the vanity definitely is a feature and it sums up the entire concept being being air. Team Fire, the textural elements within your bathroom really made us feel as though fire was represented throughout all your elements.
I am so glad the judges noticed all our sensory details. I was literally burning frankincense. Keaton was burning frankincense sticks.
Just, yeah, we just, you know, it's still a semi-construction site, but we wanted them to really come into the space and get a feel for
what it could be.
Dios, we obviously know who our top two is, but with that being said, before we announce our winner, I want to remind you that the stakes are always higher. And for this challenge, we've increased the incentive and Capitec Business have come through with a further 10,000 Rand cash injection into your budget. Yeah, that's exciting stuff indeed. So without further ado, let me talk to you about the reason why we're here, and that's to announce our winner. Officially, for our Powder Room Challenge, the winner is... Team Fire! Hello, Keita, congratulations!
Started from the bottom, now we're here.
Wow.
Well done, guys. How are we feeling? Our first challenge, our first winners?
Yeah. So proud. I think also to go from fourth to first feels like quite a nice exchange.
The 10,000 Rand, is that going to assist you?
100%.
Keep up the expensive taste.
Yes.
I like 10,000 Rand from Capitec Business. I had no idea there were extra prizes on the line for us, but
yeah.
A little cherry on top.
And to all our duos, incredible stuff. We have done and dusted our first challenge. You've definitely showed up, and I think we have a lot to learn from this as we carry on with this beautiful momentum and transforming our old lady. Put your hands together, guys. Absolutely beautiful stuff.
I don't think we expected to be in the bottom two.
Yeah, totally.
It caught us a bit off guard.
Surprise. Yeah.
Well done to the guys that took this challenge. I feel like it's well deserved because they completed it, you know, so that's something that we should look at, completing stuff. Stay tuned. Watch the show. It's about to be lit.
Turn up the heat.
Hey, I'm on fire.
You too can win big with a cash prize of 5,000 Rand from Capitec. Choose your favorite powder room from today's challenge and reply to our competition post with either earth, air, fire, or water. And don't forget to include the hashtag MyDesignRules in your answer. Good luck.
MyDesignRules is sponsored by Capitec. Better never rests.
Another feel-good production.